part of Chinese cooking is the philosophy that food is medicine, and that every ingredient has a yin or yang quality. And this bringing the yin and yang together gives you balance and harmony. So as a Chinese cook, what I learned from a very young age is that you are always trying to achieve the perfect harmony for your health and for your well-being. So in all of us, we are either very yin or yang in our quality, in our nature and our makeup. Yin means cooling, yang means fire. And if you're stressed, tired, you tend to fall in the yang category. So a bit more burnt out, and the qi, the energy is really kind of strong. If you're yin, you're kind of more calm, a bit more cold in terms of your energy, and sometimes you need a little bit of heat, a bit of injection of fire. And so if you eat a little bit more yang foods, then you're in a state of harmony. If you're too yang and stressed and tired, you need a bit of yin foods to cool you down. Now, in terms of the cooking side of it, all ingredients have a yin or yang quality. So, for example, most of your meats are yang, most of your vegetables are yin. You pair vegetables and with meat together, you get a balanced dish. But then it gets a bit more esoteric than that too. So, cooking methods. So, stir frying is kind of in the middle of yin and yang. Frying, deep frying, is more yang. And steaming is more yin. By how you cook the dish, you also impart a yin and yang quality. So this is what you have to be mindful of. And therefore, you know, Chinese food, and it's been there for centuries, it's a, you know, we never had doctors really. So food was a way of being your natural medicine. What I think is really interesting about Chinese food is that we categorize in terms of cold foods, raw foods, shentai, it's detoxifying, stir-fried, steamed. We call that nourishing, and that's because you're breaking down the food so that the body can absorb the nutrients. And then we have another category where it's restorative, so healing. So those are your superfoods or your, you know, specialist ingredients that helped with a certain aspect. So for example, your eyesight's going, people say, well, eat more goji berries, you know, and it makes sense. It's got a high amount of beta carotene, for example. You know, we've been using this philosophy for centuries, and there's a lot of truth in it. So we just need more a kind of a East and West sort of approach to this to make it more accessible to everybody.